Dave, well, first, just with Mookie Betts, another day in which he's down. How is he continuing to progress? What are you seeing from him? What was the reason for keeping him down?
He's progressing. I think for me, just looking at where he's at, it's day-to-day. Could he play? Certain. With an off day tomorrow, is it more beneficial to potentially give him 3 days off? Absolutely. We've got a long stretch coming, a lot of baseball left. So for me, my decision, I thought it was a no-brainer to give him that extra day. Is he available off the bench today? I'll make that decision when the time comes.
Has the swelling gone down in his ankle?
It has. It has gone down. Still a little soreness. And, you know, with the ankle, it's just tricky because if there's one movement, you can kind of really regress quickly with the ankle. So I want to be very mindful of that.
Lance Lynn is now here. Have you decided, I know that he's going to have a bullpen today, but have you decided as to when you're going to move him into rotation?
I think Tuesday is the day that we're targeting. And I'm going to go out there and watch his pen right now. He's excited to be here. I think he's going to be a big boost to our ball club. I didn't realize how long he and Joe Kelly have been friends, you know, since 18. And but I'm excited to get him back in the rotation with us. And the plan is Tony goes on Wednesday, and I think Julio is slated for Thursday.
How's Kershaw feeling today, and is there any more clarity on when he may return?
I'm going to go out there. He's out in the outfield right now. I'm going to go talk to him right now. So I don't know. I don't have clarity. Just seeing how he's going to play catcher shortly, and I think that we'll know more once he does that.
Any reason for pushing Julio back to the end of that?
I think with Julio, just extra days, I think just talking to the trainers, talking to Mark, gives him feeling better. So overall, kind of a little nail thing. It's something that if we can give him a couple extra days, that's the problem.
That's the only physical.
That's the only physical.
How many more is there with the ankle as he comes back? Is there any reason to think right field's better than the infield or vice versa?
No, that's a fair question. He heard it in the batter's box avoiding a pitch, but if you talk about the dynamics of second base versus right field, you could probably argue the outfield, but I think for me, giving him today as well as yesterday and the off day tomorrow, that's the thought of having him be available for anything. And so I feel that if we get him a couple extra days, which we are, he should be 100% to do whatever we need. You know what, I'm gonna go talk to Clayton right now. He's playing catch right now, so I haven't talked to him yet. So
we covered that already.
Once he plays catch, I'm gonna have a conversation on figuring out what are the next steps for him. Yeah, thank you, Juan.
Are Evan and Bruzar around?
So Evan's gonna be up. Bruzar's gonna play catch and see how he is. Then his catch play starts in about 5 minutes. But Fergie will be down. And then I'm kind of waiting to see on Bruzar.
How many more days of Rosario working with Dino and Woodward until you feel comfortable in second base?
I'll tell you, he's taken to a lot of what we've done at second base. So to your question, I feel comfortable right now. He's a baseball player, and you know, there are some things that Woody and Dino have already worked with him. So I think for me is he's going to take some second base, some center field, but also he's still a shortstop. And so him, us being mindful that he's still a shortstop, is still in play too.
How much of an adjustment is that sliding over to second? I know you guys did have a Trey at 21 as well.
It's player to player. I would say that I didn't appreciate it as much as when I learned from Trey and Gavin. But with Ahmed, it's been a lot easier as far as that quick other side of the diamond. Yeah.
What's the likelihood Kershaw tells you he's not ready?
Probably zero. But what ready means is kind of the question for me as far as when. Not necessarily if. Yeah.
So far you're listed to participate in the Faith and Family program after the game. Have you done that before?
I have done it before with different ball clubs. I'm looking forward to this. Clayton has obviously spearheaded this, and I think it's CT, Muncie, myself, and we've got Chris Pratt's going to be here. I think some musical entertainment too. I'm not sure who it is. Somebody really good. But I'm looking forward to this.
Given what happened earlier in the season with the Sisters of Perpetual Indulgence and all, is this, I don't want to say a response, but is this any more important to you because of that?
It's always important. We haven't done it in recent years, so yeah, you could say it's a response because it wasn't scheduled, but I'm glad that I'm happy we're doing it. I'm excited to be a part of it.
Surprise, Rosario, guy's played short that long has never played second base in the big league.
I think I am surprised, but he was an uber prospect coming up with the Mets, and so his kind of plan was pretty linear. And so, in that sense, I'm not surprised. And then when he went over to Cleveland, same thing. So, not surprised, but physical guy, obviously as a young player. So, his development was right there at shortstop. So, I'm not totally surprised. And I'm also not surprised that he can adjust so quickly because he's a baseball player. He just wants to play.
Well,